Hello everybody, welcome to another vlog with me and my mate Jack, and also going to Harry Potter World in Watford, London. Isn't that right, Jack? And we're going on this coach here on our way to Harry Potter World, and we'll see you at the halfway point. Hello everybody, we are now halfway onto our journey into Harry Potter World. We just had the services. Next time you'll see us will be when we arrive. Guys, we are here. Wow. Exciting, ain't it? Just wow. I am stunned. This, folks. Oh, Jack's gonna say this is Fantastic Beast.
Yeah,
Fantastic Beast and everything as well. Give you names. We're zooming in on names. It's got that, it's Newt, Queenie, look at this. Then you've got, if you can pronounce that name?
Luke,
yeah, I just put Hicks. You need to look it up yourself. Then Albus Dumbledore, and that's Grindelwald.
What?
And stuff like that. And then that's the actual poster from the film that I actually haven't seen, not that long ago. And then you've got just madness. But look. So this is from, so this is basically the script from the very first scene in the series, Privet Drive. Wow. We're going in here to the cinema. Can't film in here, so I'll see you guys in a bit. Wow. Covered under the stairs, no. Look at that. Look at how massive this is. Yep, Harry Spectacles is there.
Can't see him.
You can't see him anywhere, but that's... he's covered under the stairs from the first time you see him. So this is basically showing all the films
in
basically in different languages on what the front covers would look like. Ah. So you got basically our version.
Yeah.
And then basically you've got the American.
Yeah.
Because they call it the Sorcerer's Stone. And then you got Chinese. And then you got the official bit. And it's the same on every single one. Look at that, just mental. So we're just having to wait before we can go in, Jack.
Yeah.
Look, so you got the first one, that is that one, you got second, all in order, all the way around. Mad.
That's it everyone, this is a great haul. It is one of the first ever sets ever constructed for this series, and it is one of the largest. Feel free to take as many photos as you'd like, and I'll get back to you once the music sequence ends.
Dad. I'm saying this now, and this is especially for my dad. He would love this. I have to do this again with my dad again. I think he would enjoy this.
Yeah.
Look at that. Oh my. Hey Jack. We've got some of these. Look at all the smoke effects. It's just, wow. It gets very smoky. But look at this. This is just insane. And that is...
So, as you are visiting us through our magical mystery feature, for the first time ever at the studios, we have recreated the scene from Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix, where the Weasley twins first enter the Great Hall during exams, set up an array of fireworks, finishing off with a huge jump of fireworks, and take out Professor Umbridge. You may also notice our audio and lighting sequence was reminiscent of that very moment. The type of fireworks that Fred and George would have set off would have been created digitally in post-production. However, to get the best reactions from the actors, we're going some way to create the feeling of real fireworks in the Great Hall. Studio lights would have been used, just like we have done today. Now, as we continue to OWL Salination tables, you can come right up to the barriers, guys. Yeah, that's it. And this is the effect of when the Weasley twins would have flown over the desk and when the paper burst out into the air. So those at the back, keep gathering around. We're only going to show this effect once.
This is
if you're sensitive to loud noises, feel free to cover your ears. This is quite a loud noise effect. And don't forget to turn your phones on video report mode. So guys, keep gathering mode at the back, we're only going to show this effect once. And whenever you're ready, 3, 2, 1. Perfect. So, how that was achieved was by a small amount of air pressure being fitted in a device.
So this is the leaky cauldron from Prisoner of Azkaban. When we fought, you think it's big,
yeah,
but it's really that big.
Yeah, it's crooked.
Yeah, if you see, it's crooked from the
housekeeping.
Yep, and then if you want to see, that's what it looks like in the movie. The Leaky Cauldron. Look at this, folks. Gryffindor boys dormitory. Wow, look at this. That is, look at that, beams everything. Look at that. Now we're on to the next bit, which is the wands, folks. Got Draco, Lord Malfoy, Sirius, and now here it's Hermione, Harry, Ron, what they wore. Wow, that's mad. That's mad. And then you got the entrance. Yeah. Right, the entrance to get into the common room. This, you've got the evil, the living door, Slytherin common room.
Yeah.
Wow. You can definitely tell it's Slytherin because most of it's green. This is Slytherin common room. With Draco Malfoy, Crab, and Goyle. Gryffindor common room. No, Gryffindor common room. It's Slytherin common room. This is more posh, I think, to say the least. Then you got the Marauder's map. That is massive, Jack. Jeez, the Marauder's map. Look at how big that is. That is insane. What the heck is the Marauder's map? You got the big thing there, and look at us there. Jeez. And then footsteps, just walking up into this. This is the four Marauders. And that's there. Wow. That's the Marauders. Four Marauders. And then you got these here, you got Snape. James Potter of all people. Wow. Just insane, just see from an angle, look at that. We are now heading in to Professor Dumbledore's office. Look at some of these. Jeez. Wow. And you get some of these photos, it's just insane. It's just insane, isn't it, Jack? What?
What?
Yeah, you got Richard Harris, and then you got the that one. If you can't see it there, it's the white one. I did not see it as clear on the camera, but we're trying our best as we can.
Yeah.
But we got Richard Harris there, the Harry, and then you got the white one, which is from Hogwarts Prince,
yeah.
which I now remember, folks. If you guys can't see the swords, just go there and we'll go and have a look together here. It's going to be absolutely insane. This is to see memories, isn't it, Jack?
Mm-hmm.
The memories of life, death, future, whatever. You can see whatever, can't you, Jack?
Yeah.
Look at this. What can you see? See something?
Yeah, it's Harry.
Just something. Yeah, looks cool. It looks, and then you can see more, yeah. And then you got all this from up there. That is insane. Iconic, another iconic bit. The first time was Tom Riddle in the Half-Blood Prince. It was Voldemort. Look at that, that's what he wore, and that's what he looks there. Or in the void of the bottom of his couch. Which why was a cup? That is mental. Look at just how it looks. And that's it in the movie, folks. It's the try was a cup. It's just insane. see. Look at all this, this is insane. This is just insane. Welcome, the next bit we're in is Potion Classroom of Professor Slughorn and Professor Snape. And here we are in the Potion Classroom. There's Slughorn, just there, folks, and Professor Snape, he's just there. Look at that, how it just moves. Like, this is just mad.
Tell me, what would I get if I added powdered root of asphodel to an infusion of wormwood?
I don't know, Jerry.
You don't know?
This
well,
is
let's try again. Where, Mr. Potter, would you look if I asked you?
Look at that. The Quidditch equipment. And the next bit we're going to go to is the hut. This is the... This is Hagrid's. Oh, wow. It doesn't look that big, Jack. It looks like everything's just crammed into one small little thing.
It's the smallest set ever.
Yeah, and then to do the next bit, to get it all in one shot, you got all the brooms. The Firebolt, Nimbus 2001 and the Nimbus 2000. Wow. Just crazy. Wow. That is just mad. How that looks is stunning. So you got the vault card from the last movie, Jack.
Yeah.
And then you got the most iconic is Hagrid's motorbike. Then you got the motion ring. Wow, a motion ring. Look at that, folks. And Hagrid's motorcycle. Wow. And there's the doors of Hogwarts. Wow. Wow. That is mad. And then you got the bit that I will be looking forward to the most, because I told you this last night.
Yeah.
Is the door. Do you want to do that? The secret door in Chamber of Secrets. The Chamber of Secret Doors. Oh, my favourite part. My favourite thing in the whole of that film. What is that? And then here you've got trunk, a tune. Yeah, Professor Lupin's trunks, which actually move. Look at that, it actually moves. Look at this, this is insane.
This?
Yeah. Insane. You've seen it coming, going back in, now you can see it coming back out. That is insane. Wow. Wow. And then, you got the famous Weasley car stuck in the Whomping Willow. Wow. That's mad. There's not a lot tonight. Look at this. The Weasley household. Look at that. This is just insane. Mad. We are now in the Ministry of Magic section.
Don't.
You're not going that way yet?
No.
Do you want to look at this a bit more? Look at this. This is Letterbox at Privet Drive. Just there, just a door. Just a door. Then, we got this one with Nakini?
Yeah, Nakini.
Nakini and... That's just mad. Nakini. And all evildoers of Death Eaters, Nakini, meeting at Malfoy Mansion. Wow. This is just insane. Oh, the extras. of the Ministry of Magic. These are the extras and the portals that they can go in. That's just mad. And then you got this one, which is the orbs, which is there right in front of you. That is what's crazy. We're going to try and get this all in one clip for you, folks. The orbs look so pretty. Then you've got atoms. This is just mad.
It absolutely is.
And then look at what we've got. Salazar Slytherin's locket.
Hello everybody, we gather around in the middle of the Ministry of Magic just here. We're going to do a demonstration of a special effect and a vision effect, your first big one of the day.
Wow, it's just crazy.
So grab a spot cursor away from the front door, and that's what I'm going to show you today. So the director Chris Columbus wanted to make this a vision effect. He wanted to do it with a computer. He thought there was no way you could make it look real and make it look good. But the special effects team were like, no, it can be real and it can look even better. And here's how they did it. There's a regular front door, a letter sorting machine for the post office, which was then fixed to the letterbox at the very back. Then during the scene, the actors will stand there and light and wait for a cue from the director and flip the switch, like so. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Very nice. Now that works about as often as it does in a really good cue like that time. Now I've really used
the cloak from the film. It's one of the Deathly Hallows itself, the Invisibility Cloak. Now about 10 of these are made for the movies, but this one's extra special. It has a crushed velvet exterior with hand-printed Celtic and ancient runes, making them more magical. On the interior, however, is where we have our green screen, which is this delightfully vibrant green colour. And the reason it is this bright green is because it's the least pigmented colour in skin. So computers can pick it up above all other colours. So I'll show you how it works when Harry puts it over his body and his body disappears and his head is left floating in mid-air. So using computer technologies, I am able to get the green screen and the computer to communicate and pop myself into the Gryffindor common room at just a pop of a button. So this is of course Harry's first ever Christmas present, given to him by Dumbledore, passed down by his dad, and he's so incredibly excited to open it up on Christmas morning and show it to Ron. Although they're both rather confused as to what it is. But as he holds it up with the velvet facing the camera, so the camera and the computer can pick up the cloak. But as they turn it round and puts it on, the green becomes visible. The computer then picks up the green, replaces it with the Gryffindor common room, and allows Harry to be a floating head. Now you may remember in the same movie, Harry sneaking into the restricted section of the library, and all you see is a floating hand and lantern. But in reality, now you know, it was just Daniel Radcliffe under a blanket. So green screen is used rather a lot in the movies, for example, The Daily Prophet and The Portraits. Now you and I both know that The Portraits come to life in the movies. They have their own characters, they can move, they can talk. And it's the same with The Daily Prophet. All the images can move, like Dumbledore, Umbridge, and even Harry himself. But those snippets of movement and characterization we see was filmed separately in front of a green screen and added in months later digitally in post-production. So any of the actors on set interacting with a newspaper or a portrait, they had no idea of what the magic would become. All they could see was a very boring green screen. They didn't see the final product until about the same time we did when it was released in cinemas. Which just proves that all the actors in Potter were very good at their job, as they could talk to things that weren't even there. So thank you very much for...
And now we do the Forbidden Forest, let's go. Yes. Hagrid, look at this. This is...
Voldemort.
Lord Voldemort, but without his head. What without his head? Where's his head?
They won't have heads.
Look, in the scene he's got a head.
Yeah, but it's just the costume.
Ah, it's different. Look at this. This is... Ooh! Is that one of the centaurs, Jack? Up there. It is, Jack. And then you got Harry Potter there. And you got Buckby. Say hello to Buckby. With the smoke effect. All smoke arises from the ashes. And you see, hello. And there it is. Folks, there's Buckby. Wow. Which way do you want to go, Jack? Which way do you want to go? Which? Do you want to go this way first? Wow. That is bad. If you want to go and see anything, Jack, we have to go this way. What? Look at this. This is mad. There he is. There's Aragorn. Mad. Mad creature. Look at this. They are physically and terrifyingly everywhere you can look. Isn't that right, Jack? Welcome. Back from 9¾. My God. This is insane. You got Harry's stuff. Wow. Back from 9¾. Jeez. Look at all this. This is just a... This is just a... Do it. I'm stunned. But look at this. My Harry... Oh, my Hogwarts Express is right there. Oh my days, look at this. The Hogwarts Express. Hold on, where'd it go? Oh, Hogwarts. Right away. Wow. Wow. Welcome. In the Hogwarts Express, wow. This is as thin as I've ever seen. Look at the carriages. So it's so thin and compact.
Yeah.
It's insane. Of just literally how thin. How you can't literally like spread your arms out.
Just like the
Prisoner of Azkaban.
Yeah, Prisoner of Azkaban, Harry and the Prisoner of Azkaban. It's in this scene, folks.
Oh, in the
glass. Look at that, the glass. Prisoner of Azkaban. With the ice water that went from lemonade to ice.
Yeah.
Goblet of Fire, which is your favourite. Which is Goblet of Fire, this one, folks. Then this one is Jack.
Order of the Phoenix,
where's the first two? Order of the Phoenix, the one where they would just look like they were having a good time. In this one, Jack. It looks like they were having a good time. We have a gap. And then this one is Hopper Prince, yeah. Because they're going in order, but they missed out the first two. So it's Hogwarts Prince, this one is. Look at that, Hogwarts Prince is in this one, and then this one is Deathly Hollows.
No, Hogwarts Prince too.
Hogwarts Prince has got two? What makes it so special?
The book.
Ah, makes sense with the book, just there, folks. And now this is Hogwarts Prince part two. Part two. Trying to remember stuff, Jack, because there's a lot to remember. And then that's the other one, and then we are out. Wow. It's very short, but very narrow and very wide. Wow. But look at this. It's insane. And the very first time they met each other. Isn't it, Jack?
Yeah.
Very first time that Ron and Harry met. And then you got... And you got the final bit, so let's go this way. Wow, the home of Harry and the Dudleys. Wow. their house. The plumped old earth ant. Yes, Harry. There's no such thing as Modric. Hey, Jack. It's that ant. And then you got the
guy. Go around that way.
You can have a look here?
Yeah, you can have a look there.
Look at this, and then you got like the garden. The garden area. And then you got.
This is how she comes out.
Yep, and then you got. Somehow you might have a brand new area might be being built there. Do you think so, Jack?
Yeah.
And that's the house for Dudley's and Harry. And like us, all destinations, nothing on the wall. Wow. The Prisoner of Azkaban, wow. This is just mental. And it's so purple. Your favourite girl with purple. Look how it looks inside, Jack.
Yeah, that's the beds.
They're weird beds. I would say that again. Just insane. And he goes, who knows how you run? I had to do that. It's my favourite scene featuring that bridge. That's the famous bridge where number one bomb this. Who would lose army? And then we die, so it's horrible death. To do those with makeup effects. Then we got the creature shot. Draco Malfoy. Getting basically bitten by one of them. Look at that. That is good. And then you got the Phoenix Jack. Wow. You got four. That is mad. Harry Potter in full scale. Dumbledore in 82% scale. And you got my mind again. And from the Cup of the Fire. It's Dobby the House Elf. It's Dobby the House Elf. Look at these disgusting creatures. The mandrakes who like to bite people for no reason and scream. You got Hedwig. Jack.
Yeah.
Hedwig up the other end there, folks. Then you got Aragog there again, the Baskus. And his big, massive Baskus, folks, with his big, massive teeth, but beak. The dragons, and here it is. The Gallery of Goblins. Is this a bit you're looking forward to the most, Jack?
Yeah.
We still got
Gringotts
to do. Look at this, all to do with the goblins. The continuing binders. Jeez. Look at these in real. Look at this. And then you got these quotations. The many faces of Warwick Davis. So many. From him all the way to here, that is it. Fleetwood. Goblin Teller. Fleetwood again. And Grip Hook. Wow. The moment that me and you have been waiting for. Gringotts Bank. Look at this, Jack. Oh. Look at this. Oh my God, I'm speechless. I'm lost for words. Are you lost for words?
Yeah.
Look at this.
No, they put them at the back. They put them at the back.
Look at all these. And we're just going to film the whole way down to give you a side-to-side view of what you can see. Because look at this. This is just incredible. What are you thinking, Jack? Look at that, and you see the... Look at these. See stuff like that? Wow. It's just insane. Look, and then you got the main one. Main guy is just pointing to you guys. And we'll get some images. We'll give you some info. Here he is. The age. Yeah. Then look at this. And this takes them all the way down to the bit where they see the dragon, don't they, Jack?
Yeah.
So when they see the dragon in Gringotts, oh my. Look. Ah, this is amazing. This should be a whole section on its own. This is just mental. This is mental. Look. Wow. Look at back at that. Insane. Just insane. Then you got the green box. Oh, door from the first movie. Look at that, you see the little thing just there. Then we're gonna go through and just give you a bit more of the effect. Wow. Oh my. I'm insane. This is insane. This is just insane. Jack. Look at that. Wow. That is mad. Look at this. And then. That is just insane. Yeah. That is just insane. Oh my god. Here we go, folks. Oh my. Look at this. Oh. I say it so many times, but it's just incredible. Look at this, it's kind of been gone down. Look at this. This. It's just magical. Sorry. I'm just. Like the word that you are, Jack, lost for words. Look at all this, it's just. It's got there. Joke shop is. So that's where the joke shop is.
Hmm.
In the movie, that's where the joke shop is.
No, joke shop.
No, because it says here. Look. Badoosh.
No.
The joke shop is there, but quite. But really, you should put that over there.
Oh, it's just showing those advertisements there.
Ah, oh, makes sense. You ready to go and have a look up further?
Yeah.
Let's. In Mosley. But, oh. My days, God, years, months. Oh, Evander, absolute famous. This is absolutely mad to believe that I'm actually here. This is just sad. Here you go, Jack. Fred and George's cloak. I'll lock it up. Harry Potter slipped into. One of them lost today to purchase my Uncle Bobby magical music.
Huh.
There he is. Fred and George's shenanigans for all. It's just insane. Look at that. This is just mad. Is the icing on the cake? Oh my god! Famously caused by the Weasley brothers.
Yeah.
Fred and George. Your body can cause mischief. Let's go around here, folks. We can get a better look. Look at that. Look how big that is.
Yeah.
That,
the
first argument. Yeah. That's how they do it. Wow. So guys, I'm gonna go down there and we'll show you what it's like from the bottom down there in a minute. That's just insane. Look at this, oh my god, let's see it. Walking around, so let's go. This is just the most incredible sight I have ever seen. This is insane. It's insane, like hands of a thousand places. This is just gonna go around. Look at this. And then, folks, we're going down some steps. And then, look at this. From up here, look at that. That's breath. Taking it itself. Look at this, folks. We're just doing it from very up close this time. Wow. That is breathtaking. Folks, we are now leaving Harry Potter Studios. We've had a good day. Me and Jack have, so what we're gonna do now is get on the coach, go back home, back to mine, and I will end the vlog when I get back home. I'll talk to you guys in a bit.